Hello, my sweet tingletons, my honeysuckles. I hope that you're doing well. If you've seen my previous personal attention videos, then you should be feeling better, right? Under my recent videos, I received few comments asking me about what I'm reading, and I love to read. I'm like a bookworm. I'm not sure I like that term, bookworm, because I don't like worms. But I decided to show you one of the books that is always on my table. Not my vanity, but it's just that there are some books that I read and I put away. There are books that I read and I like to keep them in the front row of the bookshelf. I bought this book when I was 15 or 16. I don't remember what shop it was, some bookshop in Palm Beach, I think. And I just kept it ever since. This is a beautiful and delighting book about love. It is realistic, visionary. It's practical, gifting readers with a better understanding of how they can contribute to the outcome of their relationship. Everyone will be challenged and enriched by reading this. To be honest with you, I must say that right now I'm not like in love. And yet love comes in many different forms, and our life should be filled with love, and that is very important. Do you agree with me? I think I agree with myself. So, the book was published, let me see. Oh, I have some cards here. Two cards. Has not been sent to anyone. It's Armenia. It's one of the sightseeings. It's the Svartnots Cathedral ruins. There are a lot of sightseeings here. And then there is a personal picture sent to my mom by one of her friends, so I will not show that picture, right? Because it's personal. In the book, I also have a bookmark, the most recent one that I got. I actually bought two beautiful bookmarks. But one I gifted to a friend. The other one I don't know where it is. I don't know. So as you can see, it's brand new. This was not planned, I promise you. I swear. Okay, so let's see where it is. This is the page. What is happening? A little drama. My neighbor's place. Oh, they're actually leaving. I left this bookmark. I will randomly just open this book and read quite from here, because this book is like a compilation of quotes of different people about love. It also says a simple Buddhist guide to romantic happiness. I'm not a Buddhist. I do not know much about Buddhism, unfortunately. That is something that I still have to discover for myself. But the quotes are just different people. And let's see where I left it. Totally by accident. It is only with the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the eye. Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. It's the quote of Exupéry. It's one of the greatest authors. Exupéry. Tell me whether you love this author. You must, right? This is one of those authors that who speaks to the heart, and that's why he wrote this. And he has a very interesting story of his life and how he wrote his most famous book. And the second quote says, "Hatreds never cease by hate, but by love alone. This is an eternal truth." Shakyamuni. Shakyamuni. It is only with the heart that one can see rightfully. What is essential is invisible to the eye. Hatred never sees by hate, but with love only. This is an eternal truth. Do you agree with his words. I agree with his words. And you can probably tell so why I always have this book available to just take into my hands and read at any time. Because when life goes wrong, no, that song is like, when love goes wrong, nothing goes right. That's one thing I know. Because we always need even just a drop of love in our life, in our days, that can be stressful and depressing. A book like this is essential to have. Let's take a look on the inside of this book and how it's built, shall we? So when we open it, we see this color. So beautiful, one of my favorite colors. Then we get into the next page. That is yellow, the color of the sun. Another variation of the color, many colors of fire. And it says, what is love? This page is probably the reason why I gravitate towards this book so much. Because here the author is thanking his parents. With affection and gratitude, he writes, to my parents David and Carol for showing me through their love for each other an enlightened example of romantic happiness. And I think it's very sweet, and I think one of the reasons why I gravitated towards this book as a very young girl was that I felt like this book was just written with so much love, and the author put so much of himself and his own love and his personality into this. Every time that I hold this in my hands, I just kind of feel that positive energy that the author has put into this. That's the feeling I get. And all of the other writers and just people who written about love and their words here about love. And I think it just makes this book such a bright thing to hold in your hands and just to have in your home. Let's see, it's very beautifully built. Moving on. And let's read the first quad of love. It's from the Webster's New Dictionary and Thesaurus. Love is a noun. A powerful emotion manifesting in deep affection, devotion, or sexual desire. When we move on, we have this page. It's just built so beautifully, isn't it? Begin, and the author also writes something of his own from time to time. Now, open a random page and read quote about love, just like I do always with this book. Just a random page. that it puts us in different moods. If you truly loved yourself, you would never harm another. Isn't this true? If you truly loved yourself, you would never harm another. I think it's very true. I think even if we analyze the lives of people who actually started wars, those were people that were rejected of love. And that's why they had so much anger inside. No one has ever loved anyone the way everyone wants to be loved. This is also very wise, right? Because we're all very different, and the way that we love is also very different. Love, I don't know, romantically, or our parents or friends, things, our affection is also very different, because the way that we are is different. We're all built differently. Oh, I love this quote. Absence is to love what wind is to fire. It extinguishes the small. It enkindles the great. I'm even thinking I should make a video where I'm reading the squats. Just one after the other one. One after the other one. Just another page. And let's see what Oscar Wilde had to say about love. To love oneself is the beginning of a lifelong romance. Oscar Wilde. I want to end this video with the most important words in here, in my opinion. I agree with these words more than I agree with anything, as if I have written them myself. I agree with every bit of what I will read to you right now. So I've saved this for the last, so that this message is imprinted into your brain. The quote is by Daisaku Ikeda. If you sacrifice your growth and your talent for love, you will not find happiness. True happiness is obtained only by fully realizing your potential. Love should be a force, a force, a force that helps you expand your life and bring forth your innate potential with fresh and dynamic vitality. I cannot put in words how much I agree with this statement. It's a statement, it's a rule. It's one of the rules of life. If you sacrifice what you absolutely love for love, then what kind of love is that? When we love, we want our loved ones to be happy, to expand their possibilities and their talents. And those who want their loved ones to be living in a shell, to be sacrificing what they truly love for their relationship, then how much do they really care? That love can't bring true happiness, I think, because with it will always come a drop of sadness. I don't want to read all of the beautiful words in this book. I want you to read it yourselves. All I can say is that What Is Love is a book I love. And I love everything about it, the way it's designed, the amount of care put into it and into each detail. I love its aesthetics because it's just so beautiful. And I'm just so happy to have come across it and to own it. Now, if I find that bookmark that I was telling you about, I will be even happier. Maybe we will continue a series like this. Maybe on my ASMR channel, maybe on my vlog channel. Or maybe I should put the vlog ones in my ASMR channel too. I don't know yet. But I would love to share with you books I'm reading, books I love and recommend. Not all of them in a bunch. Although we could do something like that too. But just like this, giving each book some time, dedication, and love. This was it for today's video. I hope to see you very, very, very soon. I'm sending you all of my gratitude and my love. See you in my next video. Stay with love. Bye. In the end, I want to thank my lovely Patreons, Andre, William, Brent, and all of my patrons, and all of my subscribers. See you all very soon. Join me on Instagram.